yesterday. I didn't think this would be that big a deal. Number one, the idea that La Russa, the game has passed them by. First off, they're in first place. That's the first thing. They're about 10 games over 500. This is a team that's not done a thing in years. They brought it. They had Renteria there the last couple of years. They collapsed at the end of last year. They were awful against the A's. And they brought La Russa in, who's won 3 championships, 2 in each league, and is a Hall of Fame manager. So the idea that now at 76, the game is passed him by, which is what I heard a lot of people say today, that is a bunch of crock. That is somebody, whether it's a young kid, my son, your son, that is a baseball guy who knows anything about baseball. That is somebody who knows nothing about managing in Major League Baseball. Zero. La Russa is as sharp as he's ever been. Just because he's 76 years of age doesn't mean he can't identify with the young player. And if you think he can't identify with the young player, he lost 2 of his best players who haven't even played this year. Robert, the kid from Cuba, and Jimenez in spring training, and he's 10 games over 500 with a 4-game lead. So the idea that for a franchise that can't get out of its own way in the last 7 years, and he's won 3 championships, and he's a Hall of Famer. So that's number one. Number two, he got a take sign, this kid Mercedes. I know he's been everybody's flavor of the month. He got a take sign. It's 3-0. It's the top of the 9th inning. There's 3 people in the building. There's nobody watching on television. Everybody wants to go home. Nobody watched this game. It's 16-4. He got a take sign. The manager, knowing that he's a young kid, might not know the, you know, quote-unquote correct thing to do, put a take sign on the hitter. He knew he had a take sign. He swung anyway. That's wrong. That is, and even Van Gundy, who disagrees with my premise, agreed with that is, you can't do that. That's number two. Number three, what does the kid think he's going to get out of this? He hit a 47-mile-an-hour fastball out of the ballpark with some pitcher, I don't even know who it was, who threw the pitch, right? Nobody cares about some meaningless home run in the top of the 9th inning with a 14 or a 12-run lead against a utility infielder who's on the mound just to get the game over with. Yeah, that is absolutely absurd. He thinks that's a big deal, that he hit a home run against some a kid who's throwing 40 miles an hour, who's a utility ball player, shouldn't be in the major leagues. That is a significant accomplishment. I mean, that would be like me going out there in a mixed doubles tournament and acing some 3-0 tennis player left and right, a lady, just because I want to show you that I'm tough. Who cares? All right, let her hit the ball back. Hit the ball to shortstop and get the hell out of the game. That's number three. Number four, the idea as Alex Wood and Trevor Bauer and Lance Lynn, the fact that these major league players are all upset at La Russa for apologizing to the Twins, which he did, and obviously the Twins didn't like it because they hit a batter the next day. Now, it was harmless. It was in his legs, but the Twins played a little payback and hit a batter the next day. So obviously the Twins in their dugout were not pleased, all right? So the White Sox and the Trevor Bowers of the world, I could put in a thimble what Trevor Bauer knows about the history of baseball and what is the right thing to do and what is the wrong thing to do. Same thing goes for Alex Wood. In a thimble, I don't care if he plays. And he wouldn't know who Lou Gehrig was if he fell on him. In a, the half of them don't even know who Jackie Robinson is. In a thimble. That is not the problem. You get nothing out of hitting a home run with a 16-4 lead in the 9th inning. I don't understand why, well, you know, it's big, big baseball. That once they put the positional player in, all bets are off. Oh, nonsense, all bets are off. Don't even swing. Take 4 strikes and get on. Nobody's watching the game. Don't tell me it's entertainment. There's nobody watching the game. There's no eyeballs on the sets, and there's nobody in the stadium. This is not an entertainment scenario. Everybody wants to go home. The groundskeeper, the official scorer, the stadium operator, the scoreboard operator. They want to get the hell out of there. They're not interested in seeing some meaningless home run. That's number four. And the idea that Bauer and Wood and Lynn are all up in arms. How dare they get on the kid? What a job. It's baseball. Old school rules go to hell. Nonsense. And for all the players out there who are making this big fuss about how the game has passed La Russa by, I'm going to give you a player right now who just passed away who we spent weeks extolling. Weeks. Whether it be the sport, whether it be talk shows, whether it be Cooperstown, the Atlanta Braves, you name it. Weeks. Henry Aaron. Okay? Do you think Henry Aaron, a man of tremendous class, in a 16-4 game in the ninth inning, is going to disobey a take sign in the top of the ninth on a 3-0 pitch against a mop-up shortstop to hit a home run. And this is the guy who's got more home runs than anybody in the history of baseball, who knows a thing or two about hitting the ball out of the ballpark. Do you think Henry Aaron, in that situation, is going to swing the bat? Yes or no? Does Bauer know who Henry Aaron is? Okay? Does Alex Wood know anything about Henry Aaron? Does Lance Lynn know a thing or two about Henry Aaron? I doubt it. Does he know anything about him? Does he know about all his greatness with home runs? Does he know about Tom House? Does he know about Al Downing? Does he know about Cincinnati in game one of the 74? Do they know anything about Henry Aaron? Again, do you think Henry Aaron in that situation against a backup shortstop to get out of the game, they did that in the old days too, do you think Henry is going to disobey, you know, Eddie Matthews' 3-0 take sign, and the players who are moaning and groaning about the old school stuff, they don't know who Eddie Matthews is either. Do you think, and he managed the Braves and managed Henry, do you think that Henry Aaron is going to disobey 3-0 at 16-4 in the top of the ninth inning to swing? If you think he would, you know nothing about Henry Aaron. Nothing. What's good for Aaron is good for the gander. Don't swing. 19 in front of the hour, we continue. We're at Mad Dog Unleashed.
Stop tweeting when you stunk. What have they been doing for 2 years? They should have been on top of this. The fact that I got...
With attitude. Mad Dog Sports Radio. It's Mad Dog Unleashed with Christopher Russo. Back to you, doggy.
Of using big leagues in baseball or basketball and football really isn't perfectly analogous to this situation. Both of those sports have clocks. The beauty of baseball is there's no clock.
Right.
Could have come back in the bottom of the ninth and made that interesting.
What are you kidding me? They had a 12-hour. Hold on now. Interesting. The game was 16-4. The biggest upset, the biggest comeback in history of baseball is 10 runs. That's 12. So, in other words, the Minnesota Twins, who are 15 games under 500, would have done something in baseball that has never been done since 1865. Now, come on.
That's
that
the
game was over.
Of baseball, Chris. That's
oh, stop. If your argument is, you know, that's the way it goes, he's allowed to swing, that's one thing. Don't talk about comebacks. Not when it's 16-4 in the ninth inning. That's ridiculous.
Well,
don't talk about
my
comebacks.
Second point,
that's not
my
fair.
My second point is about La Russa. About taking that young kid and saying he's unsportsmanlike and he's cheating the game. How about La Russa stealing signs using electronic devices in the late 80s?
When did he do that?
In the late 80s. Jack McDowell.
Where's the evidence of that? Well, where did they steal signs? First off, it didn't help them because they lost 2 out of 3 World Series. Where did they steal signs? Give me the proof on that, Paul. Give me the proof. So now we're going to recuse. You want to get on La Russa for allowing McGuire and Canseco to do steroids? All right, you can make it and losing control of that sequence. Go ahead. Don't accuse La Russa of stealing signs. That's not fair. That's not fair. I mean, that is completely out of line. And don't let me hear about comebacks. There has never been a 13-run comeback in the history of the sport in the bottom of the ninth inning. So let's not go there. You want to sit there and tell me, you know what, tough, the game has to be played. It's Major League Baseball. All right, you can go ahead. But don't bring up comebacks. That I'm not buying. Now when they've been playing a game for 155 years and it's never been done. It wasn't about to be done 2 nights ago. Paul in Tampa. He's on Mad Dog Unleashed. Paul, good afternoon. How are you today, pal? What's going on? Paul.
Doggy, I love the show. I just found it. I wish I found your text. But I think we have... is ignoring his sign. If you miss.
We have a bad line there. I'm sorry there, Paul. We are not going to take bad lines here today. We got too many people waiting. Dave in New Orleans. He's with us here on Mad Dog Unleashed. Dave, good afternoon. How are you today, pal? What's going on? Dave.
Hey, I got to agree with the previous caller. It's like, do you want to make history and be the team that blows the 12?
Oh, come on. Your argument, Dave, is that Twins are going to come back and win the game? Is this your argument?
Are you... professional athletes.
Oh, stop. No, come on. No. Dave, off the phone. Off the phone. You want to argue something that makes sense? It's different now. Players want to express themselves. I don't like it, but okay. Please don't come on a national talk show and sit there and talking about the possibility of a Twins comeback in the bottom of the ninth inning when it's 16-4. That I can't listen to. That I'm not going to listen to. The game is over. That game is not going to be, the game is finished. It's a loss. It's never happened in the history of Major League Baseball. Don't go there. We'll take a timeout. We continue. We're Mad Dog Unleashed. Give me the... Nice to have you with us as we talk. Louie in Iowa says hello, and he's on Mad Dog Unleashed. Louie, good afternoon. How are you today, pal? What do you have? Lou.
Hey, Mad Dog. Nice to talk to you. Hey, okay, so... 2 weeks ago, Anthony Rizzo was playing with the Cubs, and the Cubs were getting shellacked. And they brought Rizzo in, and it was a clip. It was playing on all the shows and everything. Rizzo threw a slider, and he struck one of the better hitters out. I can't even remember the team, right?
It's Rizzo his best laughed. Friend. I forget who it was, but it was Rizzo's best friend. Let's not forget that. I think it was Freeman.
Oh, okay.
It may have been Freeman of the Braves, Freddie Freeman. But
okay.
It's his best friend.
Okay, well, I didn't know that was his best friend, number one. But, okay, but that's a different scenario. If that guy hits the homer, would it have been a problem for that guy to hit the homer even though they're shellacking the Cubs? So the problem here
Lou, stay there. They got three problems with it. Number one, he had a 3-0 take sign. So the player disobeyed his manager by swinging on a 3-0 take sign.
Agreed.
It was like he didn't have a sign. He had a sign. Don't swing. He's the boss.
Agreed.
The kid swung.
Agreed.
Number two, what do you get? What sense of accomplishment do you get as an athlete by hitting a home run from a reliever who's throwing 46 miles an hour? The home run shouldn't even count. It's a joke. What sense of accomplishment as an athlete do you get? He's not playing. Come on, he's not getting paid for hitting that home run in that situation. Well, what sense of accomplishment is he getting?
Doggy, the home run counts, and I agree.
No, it doesn't.
The home run counts. A home run is a home run. I disagree. What's your other point?
No, it's not the home run, Louis. It's not a home run. It's a home run. It doesn't mean a damn thing. I mean, that home run does not count. It's not going to mean any extra money for him down the road. It doesn't include any bonus money. The White Sox are not going to give the kid more money in the next contract because he hit a home run at 16-4 in the ninth inning against some utility infielder throwing 46 miles an hour. Now, let's get to the bottom. You want to sit there and tell me this is a new age of baseball, the young kid doesn't understand the etiquette, and we have to live with it, and we have to move on and let them be, you know, play the game? Fine. Argue that. Don't sit there and talk about finances. This is not going to have any impact at all, how much money the kid's going to make. And let's not talk about the fact that Twins are trying to come back in the bottom of the ninth inning. That is absurd. And the Rizzo-Freeman thing, I think it was Freeman, that was a little different. They're buddies. Rizzo's an, you know, that's a little different. Now, they made a mockery of it too, but he didn't hit a home run either. That's a little different. This is not a friend situation here. Is Sean in Virginia, Mad Dog Unleashed. Sean, good afternoon. How are you today, pal? What's going on? Sean.
Hey, Chris, how's it going?
Sean,
I agree with you on most fronts here. I think if Rocco Baldelli thought the Twins had a chance to come back in the game, he wouldn't be throwing a relief pitcher who couldn't break the speed limit on a highway. So that's the first part. But the only issue I would take, and I think when you talk about La Russa, I think everything you're saying is spot on as far as how important he is to the White Sox and where they are right now and his championship pedigree and all that. But the reason why we're still talking about this is because I think he went over the top in trying to be magnanimous with the Twins and trying to apologize to the Twins. You know, you got a problem with the guy swinging on a 3-0 count when he's given a sign not to. I got no problem with that. You can handle that in-house. But I think he went over the top in the press conference. I know he's asked direct questions. He's got to answer those. but I think he made it a bigger deal than it is. This would have been a forgotten moment of a game, you know, that was, it was over, you know, 2 hours before that. But I think he perpetuated, and that's why Bauer and Wood and all these guys are still talking about it. That's why social media is still a buzz about it. I think La Russa himself made this
first
a much
off,
bigger
La Russa,
deal than actually
La Russa was. La Russa could do anything he wants. He's a Hall of Fame manager. He's one of the top three or four managers that are shown in the history of Major League Baseball. I mean, McGraw, Casey, Sparky, La Russa. I mean, there's not many better than La Russa in the history of the sport. Number two, the Twins were annoyed by it because they threw at the kid in a close game in the top of the seventh inning in the next game. So the Twins were annoyed about it. So you can make an argument that La Russa was trying to defuse the situation. We'll continue with the calls in a sec. We'll also have a conversation with Steve Phillips. Come on back.